The Great Harbour of Tara.
Where was that harbour? Which harbour?
So that's Wellington Harbour. So, sorry, to go back to the, so that I don't get misinformation out there. So, Tara and Tau Toki and their people migrated to and settled throughout the Lower North Island. Their descendants included the tribes of Ngāi Tara, Rangitani, Mau Poko, Ngāti Apa, and Ngāti Ira. And Tara's name is immortalised in many prominent landmarks. The Māori name for Wellington Harbour is Te Whanganui a Tara, or the Great Harbour of Tara.
Yeah,
I was going to say as well, the Belmont Domain, or the regional park, is 3.5 hectares of, 3.5 hectares, wow, that's tiny.
That's just a walk around.
Yeah. 3,500 hectares of walkways that you could go on with your dogs, with your horses, with your mountain bikes. There's plenty to explore, and there's walks for everybody.
Just a disclaimer there, there are parts that you can't go in which have signs that specifically which specifically say this is the livestock area where there's actual farms operating, where you can't go with your dogs. So they're like
for the protection of the livestock.
So yeah, in terms of this walk, it's gonna be a nice short one. It's gonna be very beautiful. I hope you guys enjoy and see what it's like to go through here. And yeah, I'm gonna sign out, so enjoy the walk. I'm Dan.
I'm Brian.
Guys, enjoy.
And don't forget your waterproof shoes.
And also don't forget thumbs up and subscribe.
Thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. If you don't, you won't get any chocolate cake.
Yeah. You hear that? No chocolate cake for you.
We'll be right back. So we did a little blunder.
Okay.
And we forgot the bag for that one.
Oh, what? How did that? Oh, that came off there. Okay, that's why.
So this one is going to have to hand carry that one. Or I get back. Oh my gosh.
Don't get in the water.
I can.
Come around. Oh. Stomp, stomp. Oh, no.
Oh no, or is afraid of being on the bridge. Water!
Wow, okay, no, Aaron, get away from that edge, because that's like... It's because they're not diverting the water properly. He's fine. This is cool.
Hey, Dad.
Yeah.
I can see you in the camera. I can't even.
Are you alright? I'll meet you up there. Not far.
Parkour! Am I doing parkour? I think it's wet too. It's very deep spot.
Riley, over here!
You want me to run, or are you gonna?
Yeah, I got it. Yeah.
You chasing after him.
There's essentially a camping ground here. So, there is, I think you've probably got a recording of it, but there is a flying fox, apparently.
Yeah.
Which goes...
for the camping ground.
Well, yeah, there is a registration box there. You don't do it online or anything. You literally put it in there, and then it's a gold coin donation, I'm pretty sure.
It makes it really nice, especially since it's undercover, so you don't have to wait for night time and stuff. It's generally quite dark.
Oh yeah, see, it's okay, it's not gold coin donation, but it's pretty cheap. So for all of us, it's $20 a night.
Yeah.
So it's pretty cheap.
And I do think it is cheaper if you're part of a...
the cold, apparently. And Riley's hands are freezing.
I'm freezing.
Yeah, it's really cold. It's like through my jacket.
I took my other jumper.
I mean, and this isn't an intensive walk. It's very flat.
But it is a difficult walk for
terrain. Yeah, terrain's difficult.
Whoa.
In terms of steepness, not very steep.
Are they can
you,
oh.
You know, you can. You can see it. Yeah, all the rocks coming down from all the weather we've been having lately. A lot of rain over the last few months.
I would say if you're coming on this track in the summer, when there's less rainfall, it's probably a bit easier. But you do have to still do some rock climbing at the end.
Yeah, it does get a bit more, like, definitely gets trickier. I have done it with this little one, though.
I was going to say, we have done it before without the pack, before we got the pack that he sits in.
Yeah.
We did this one.
Doing it again.
And it was one of the reasons why we decided to get the pack, because we did this track without it.
Aaron, I'm going to have 3 hours of footage of you just standing playing with a tree. Up we go. Yeah. Oh wow. Yeah, it's all fallen over. So you'll have to take it.
Quite a bit more swollen than what we're using from it. Because I didn't get wet until the very end last time. Oh, this is very flooded, this one.
Oh, it made a hole.
So the trail is actually blocked.
On the left.
We have to go straight across, I'm pretty sure.
Why? What?
Because this was the trail.
Yeah, the trail is like gone. I don't know what happened.
There's water down my back!
How did that happen? Like it sunk.
It's a tree.
It like sunk though.
It was probably on the roof.
Up. There you go. Wow, the tree's like totally falling down the cliff.
So, all we can go to the back for us down there.
Yeah, it'll be better. Yeah. Come on. Oh, jeez. Oh, it's a vine. It's stuck on my bone. Now we're going under a tree, right this height. Under the tree. Oh god. Oh, ready Riley? 1, 2, 3, jump! Jump!
The child is not allowed to cross the river without us, so he's throwing tantrums.
Yeah.
So they might have had this waterfall for refuge or
maybe like Otari they would have put traps down, but not too much in the way of wildlife here.
It's super cold.
It's quiet.
Quiet? Not that quiet. Water's running.
Well, the water is in like, you don't hear the bird life.
Oh, yeah. Like no nature, yeah. Wilton. So it's surprising. It's quite...
Bless you.
Bless you.
Bye.
Come on. Last time his shoes were soaked. Yeah. Well, we didn't know. We didn't know what this walk was like.
I mean, it is in the name.
Hence why we do these videos.
Why?
Right?
Why?
So people can see and see what it's like. And then they can pick and choose from the walks around Wellington, New Zealand.
Purely subjective as to what you think is family friendly. It's all what you're up to. Obviously there's more risk to doing this one with kids.
We'll be right back.
Yeah.
Oh no!
This is all destroyed from the last time we went.
Yeah.
Dan fall over counter number one. So this is currently a bit extra off trail. Come on! It's not usually this difficult. But it is extra difficult, and then on top of that, we also don't have the baby carrier, which is making Riley super grumpy because he just wants to swim in the water. Phoenix!
Keep going straight, Aaron. Bye.
I did it!
Well, I have at least broken the seal and my foot is soaking. Ugh. Aaron can go anyway. He doesn't have dogs, he doesn't have a backpack, doesn't have a baby on his back.
You can come down further and then there's a route you can hold on to. Hang on, Aaron, don't face that way, turn around. Turn around.
No, I'm going to that one.
Yeah, there where mom's pointing. Yeah, good.
And then down. And then... Oh! And follow the moon. Yes, yes.
God, this is very difficult when the weather is bad and you have kids.
Very, and you don't have a backpack for that one.
Very difficult.
I'm tired. Like, I'm just mentally tired.
Mm. I am because of the time.
Good problem solving, Aaron. It's a bit sing-songy. completely up to my ankles. My boots are soggy. I have a lake in my boots.
Dan has given up. Aaron has given up.
Dragging his feet all the way out here. Now coming back, he's like sprinter, Usain Bolt. Listen to the rock. I absolutely love this rock. I'm not sure what it is. So this is where we spent how long trying to get Aaron across, and there he is. this is a very... Oh, it's the wrong sign. I thought it was the wet foot track sign.
This is very waterfall track.
This is very waterfall track. This is a very aptly named track.
Wet foot track.
We have a very wet feet.
Aura has wet feet, Phoenix has wet feet, Aaron has wet feet, Dan has wet feet, I have wet feet, Riley has wet feet. Why? Riley just walked through a fern.
He does have wet.
So how did everybody find that walk?
Good. Yes, my ankles are a bit sore. It was very challenging, especially this one.
My ankles.
This one was very challenging.
The dog also made it challenging. I had to carry her across some of the water
bits. I think the easiest
bits.
One out of all of this was Riley.
Yeah.
Didn't do anything.
Yeah.
Just sat there.
Yeah.
Chilled.
So shall we go and do the loop track? That's definitely the hardest one we've done yet.
Try again.
Would not recommend to do it with children.
Try again.
Just children will be okay.
I mean...
And if you have a backpack.
Yeah, if you have a backpack. Technically, I mean, you could, it's just not the easiest. It's a lot easier, as Dan and Aaron found out, when you give up on keeping your feet dry.
Yeah, bring some shoes that you don't care get wet.
And a spare change of clothes, and a towel, and come on, Aura. And a spare change of socks, and a spare shoes.
You don't need
to. Just spare everything. Spare
I did manage
underpants.
To do it last time that we came here without getting my feet wet at all.
Yeah, well, we've come after a little bit of rain, and so the river, the stream, the dry creek, or ironically called dry creek, is very swollen.
It's very wet.
So it's a little bit trickier to cross.
It's even overflowing here.
Yeah, it's a little bit trickier to cross than normal. And then on top of that, there's lots of slips where the trail has completely disappeared, where you have to do lots of, like, off track. I was actually still trying to keep my feet dry at the end. Yeah. That is the end of our Belmont walk. It is a 8 out of 10 difficulty.
It's very hard. And I'll see you guys next time.
I'm not. There you go.
See you guys next time.
Bye.
Say bye.
To me, it's a 0 out of 0.
Okay.
So
then.
It's max points.
Say bye.
No.
Did you say bye?
Bye.
Like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.
Fire!